We are back now with the Hot Box, going one step beyond the headlines. And tonight, the incredible story of 33 miners trapped in a mine in Chile. Rescue crews made contact with those miners more than 2 weeks after the mine collapsed. Getting them out could take months. I'd like to introduce you now to Father Claude Pomerleau, who's a political science professor at the University of Portland. You were in Santiago as all of this unfolded. You just got back yesterday.
I just got back yesterday. I left on Sunday, a few hours after they announced that they had made contact with 33 miners. So I was in a house with a family of Chileans, and one of the kids was listening to the TV set because they've been watching the TV for 3 weeks, almost 3 weeks, while these miners are down there. Every day, this has been a national drama. And the Teresita came in, and she said, they found the miners. Well, people jumped up. They were hugging and crying and jumping up and down, and then they had to take me home to get to my apartment and then to get to the airport. And downtown Santiago was like a wedding of 6 million people.
Really?
Everybody was beeping their horn. People were stopping, jumping out of the car, hugging people on the street, going through red lights, and people were saying, beep, beep, yeah, that's great. So it was absolutely, the city went berserk, because it's the first time they had something to celebrate since the earthquake in late February, early March.
Well, and certainly we have to talk about the earthquake as well, because you were there around that time as well.
Right. The first plane that landed after the earthquake, and I was there for the transfer of the mandate from Bachelet, the president at the time, to the new president, who was the president during this crisis of the miners, Piñera. And as they were transferring the mandate of office, two 7.0 earthquakes shook us. I was in a house, a private house, and my chair was moving around. And of course, the chandeliers were swinging back and forth. But the Chilean people really put their shoulder to the grindstone and just started pushing and said, we're going to recover, we're going to do this well. But it took the glitter off the 200th anniversary of the city. And then comes the mining disaster. So it was the sort of the day that you could just celebrate and explode and have a good time. Now, a lot of controversy is coming out about the mine, because this was a maverick mine by a Hungarian immigrant right after World War II, who was doing rather well by not following the rules. Chile has had one of the safest histories of mines of any country, including the United States, China.
And it is a big part of the economy there, Mike.
Oh, it's a huge part of the economy. So in Copiapó, the south of Chile, where this mine was, this was a maverick mine. They didn't have a good escape. We see it as a very successful module down there so that they survived, but nobody expected them to survive, because this company was cutting corners. They weren't using enough beams for strengthening, and you have companies have not been building schools around the area. Just the clinic, if there are Chileans out there listening to me, they're going to be shocked that a Catholic priest quotes from the clinic. This is a very notorious newspaper, but they have some of the best articles, sort of yellow journalism, but really get to the bottom of things. It's called The Damned Mine, and they explain how this mine has cut corners and why this should not have happened. And so once they get the miners out of there, right now they've got psychologists that are gathering around, and they're going to try to figure out, how do we tell the miners that they're going to be there for a while?
I mean, possibly until Christmas. My heart.
Can you imagine a dark little room?
But they're alive and they're in communication. Father, thank you so much for bringing us this perspective and your story. And please travel safe the next time you go there. You come back with amazing stories. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Stephanie. Thank you.
Let's talk a little.